Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you writing and reading array of structure into file with the help of C programming. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Now, first I am going to demonstrate you how you can write array of structure into file, then I will be demonstrating you how you can read array of structure from file. First, I am going to include two header files that are stdio.h and stdlib.h. Now, I am going to define main function. Inside main function, I am going to declare a file pointer that is fp. Now, I have to create a structure. I have to create array of structure. So before that, I have to declare a structure because structure is user defined data type. So I am creating structure for book, which will have two members, book number and book name. So book number is of integer type and book name is of character array type. Now I can declare an array of structure for book. So size is 5. It will receive 5 book details in terms of book number and name. And integer variable I is declared. Now I have to open a file in which I can write this array of structure. So name of file will be book.txt and I am going to open it in WB mode. So W is for writing and B is for binary. I will be using fread and fwrite functions for writing and reading purpose. That's why I am using this binary format, because fread and fwrite work for binary files only. After opening the file, I have to check whether the file is opened successfully or not. So for that purpose, I am going to implement this if condition, which is checking fp whether it is null or not. So if fp is containing null, then it will be printing this message: error, cannot open file, and exit will be terminating execution of the program. Otherwise, the statements which are available after if will be executed. So here I have to call printf so that I can show this message: enter 5 books details. Now I have to implement for loop, which will repeat 5 times. Now with the help of these statements, I am going to read book number and book name. So read these three statements carefully. First, printf will be printing enter % book number. So here I have to use i+1. So this will be printing enter first book number, then second time when I will be 1, so it will be printing enter second book number, and so on. To clean buffer, I have called fflush. I am passing std in, then scanf will be reading book number from user. With the help of these three statements, you might have understood I am going to read book name. So the message enter first book name, enter second book name will be displayed on output screen, and the entered name will be stored in B array at I indexes automatically. So this loop will be reading 5 book numbers and 5 book names. Now I have to write all these information into a file. For that purpose, I have called fwrite. So fwrite function is passing four arguments. First is b, that is array of structure. Second argument is size of struct book, that is denoting size of each block which is available in array. Third argument, 5, is denoting how many blocks or how many elements are available in this b array. And fp is pointing destination, that is file pointer. So fp is pointing to the file, that is book.txt. So this array will be stored in book.txt file. After that, I can print the message. Data is stored successfully. And then I can call fclose fp. So this is the first part of this video, which is reading information from user and writing the received information from user into the file. And the file name is book.txt, which will be created on the path, that is ctc bin, because this source code is stored in bin folder available in C drive. So the files book.txt will be created automatically in this path only. Now I am going to execute this code. So you can see it is asking for 5 book details. So I have to enter 5 book details now. So you can see I am entering different book numbers and book names. So I have entered 5 book numbers and 5 book names. So it is showing the message data is stored successfully. Now I have to check whether the data is stored successfully or not. So I have to open bin folder that is available in ctc. Here I have to search book.txt. So I have pressed B. So it is showing the files which starts from B alphabet. So book.txt is available. You can see it is having contained in form of binary. Some are readable and some are not readable. So this text is available in binary format because I have used WB mode. So array of structure is stored successfully in the file that we have seen right now. Now we have to convert this code so that we can read the data which is available in book.txt. So for that purpose, I am removing these statements. Now you can see the remaining code. Here header files are available, structure is available, and main function is containing some set of instructions. So here in place of W mode, I am using RB mode, which is responsible for reading content from file only. Now I have to call the function which can read data from file, and data is array of structure. So with the help of this fread statement, I am going to read array of structure from file. So this first argument is b, that is array. Size of struct book is denoting size of each block which is available in array. 5 is indicating how many blocks we want to read from file. So it is 5. And file pointer is the source now, which is denoting the name of file, that is book.txt, from where we have to read array of structure. After reading array of structure, we have to display the results on output screen. So for that purpose, I am calling printf, which will display the message book details on output screen. Now to print 5 book details, I have to repeat a loop. So this loop will be displaying the messages on output screen. This way I have implemented printf statements which will be displaying book number and book name on output screen and with the help of B array of structure. After that I have called F close, so F close will be closing the opened file automatically. So this way F read is reading data from file, and with the help of for loop I am going to display the data on output screen. So this is the second program which I am demonstrating in front of you. So this program will be reading data from file automatically, and the received data will be displayed on output screen. I don't have to enter anything while executing this code. So now I am going to execute this code so that you can see whether it is printing correct results or not. So you can see on output screen it is reading 5 records which were available in file successfully with the help of fread function. I have not entered anything right now. So I have demonstrated you two different programs. First is reading data from user and writing those received data into the file. The second program is reading data from file and displaying those data on output screen. And I have used two functions, fwrite and fread. So I hope you have understood how we can write array of structure into file and how we can read array of structure from file. And this is beneficial for storing bulk data into the file. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Thank you for watching this video.